Hello, it's very exciting today because today's the day that I'm gonna announce who won the prizes for the best YouTube videos that you guys made this year. I have to say, it was perhaps the best year of entries I've ever seen of YouTube videos made by our students here in York. Well over 30 of you made videos, and it turned out to be a really difficult choice deciding who should win the awards. And I could have given prizes to many, many of the videos, and in the end, I decided to choose 6 categories, and I'll give 6 prizes to different students, each of whom had something innovative, interesting, or cool about the video that they'd made. So, without further ado, on to the first award. And the first award goes for the best cinematography. In a way, it's for the best technical tricks that anybody put into a video. And I watched this video and I thought, I wish that I knew how to do that. I wish that I could make my own face speak out from a mobile phone. And so here is our first prize-winning video.
When I say smartphone, you're not instantly going to think of polymers. However, if you've got a slim smartphone, polymers are already making your battery work. And in the future, all our smartphones' displays may well be using polymers to make them light up. So, how does this all work?
Nick Yates, many congratulations. If you ever want a job editing my videos for me, you've got it. I don't pay anything, but you know, you could certainly add something to the kind of staid presentations I normally give. The second award is for the best use of props. This video showed an adept use of a range of different props, explaining the polymer chemistry that was in them, and using those props, the person involved managed to whip themselves up in their kitchen an omelette. I have to say, it might not have been the way that I'd have made an omelette, but it was a very impressive video explaining the polymers in what is a very attractive kitchen. Let's have a look.
Now that we've chopped our onions on our low-density polyethylene board, we're ready to fry the onions a little bit and make them a little bit glassy. To do this, we're going to use this frying pan, which actually has a Teflon non-stick coating. This was invented by a chemical company called DuPont, and it makes sure that the food doesn't stick and burn to the pan while we fry the food.
So, Cohen Voskul, many congratulations, and I can't speak Dutch, so I hope I'm somewhere close to the right pronunciation there. By the way, when you cook an omelette, really, really hot pan, cook it really fast. You could have even talked about the proteins in the egg setting by cross-linking. Even more polymer chemistry going on in the pan. The third prize goes for the best music. And I use the word music with a lot of caution, to be quite honest. There was just one student who really attempted to make their own music, or create their own song, if you like, to go with their video. And I felt that they were sufficiently brave. They even noted in their video themselves that it was a potentially career-ending move, because they wrote a rap to describe polymer recycling. Let's have a look.
Plastic bags, some say 10 to 20, others say 1,000 years to decompose. So why the great divide? Truth is, no one really knows. It's a long time nonetheless due to high molecular stability. It arises from strong covalent bonds, resulting in practically absent volatility. So the next step for plastic bags is to make them biodegrade via enzyme-catalyzed hydrolysis. But is it really worth the trade? This process needs oxygen and sunlight, which they don't get underground. So ester bonds won't break in landfill. For decades they'll be around. And when they do decompose, you can be left with metals like cobalt and lead, which we all know are toxic, poisoning the environment dead. So the next time you see biodegradable, don't take it on face value, because there's issues to consider if the environment's important to you.
Jai Mystery, you're a brave man. A rapping first year student rep. Don't give up the day job yet. I'm not sure that they'll be on the phone with a great music career, but you did what was right in the video. You took a risk, you tried to present something with a bit of personality, and that wins you a great deal of credit. The fourth prize goes for best location of any of the videos. And I have to say I was jealous of this location. First of all, it was filmed somewhere spectacular. I never thought anyone could film there. And secondly, the student making this, she was in California. California, at Easter. I mean, I went to Whitby. And what was remarkable is she was explaining the polymers in aeroplanes and aeronautics, and she recorded the video while flying a plane.
Well, of the polymers I'll be concentrating on in this video are polymers in aviation. I'll be talking you through the uses and applications of these polymers at Liverpool Airport here in California.
Windshields on both commercial aircraft and smaller aeroplanes need to be strong enough to withstand changes in pressure, adverse weather conditions such as hail and bird strikes whilst in flight. There are two main polymers which have properties for dealing with these, Lexan and Plexiglas. However, each come with their own advantages and disadvantages.
So Megan Spencer, fantastic stuff, really great video, loved watching you fly, hate flying myself, have to do it for work, could never ever fly a plane. I have to say, that instructor who was sat next to you, what did he make of all that? I mean, seriously, you explaining polymer chemistry while you're flying around in a plane? I mean, what did he think? The fifth prize goes for a video I thought was particularly beautiful and well explained. And the fifth prize is for the best artwork in any of the videos. And many of you have real skills in your artwork, lots of good choice of images, some really good hand-drawn images. But there was one person who really brought the video to life with beautiful artwork, really clear explanations of the polymer chemistry. Let's have a look at what they did here.
Spacecraft, such as NASA's space shuttle, also face harsh conditions. Materials have to stand exposure to UV, resistance to large temperature extremes, especially those on re-entry, and being able to function in a vacuum. In spacecraft, polymers are commonly used in thermal protection, adhesives, and electrical components. Let's look at them individually. Not all areas of the shuttle experience the same heat on re-entry, so different materials are used at different points. The nose cone and tips of the wings experience up to 2,000 degrees on re-entry, so they need a very heat-resistant material. Reinforced carbon-carbon is a composite material that's used for this. It's made by spinning the polymer, polyacrylonitrile, into strands and then heating without oxygen in a process called prolysis. This leaves pure carbon fiber filaments that are then set in a graphite matrix and heated until solid. This material maintains its properties at up to 2,000 degrees Celsius. Although very heat resistant, it's only used to cover the wing and nose tips as it's brittle and heavy.
Matthew Hawkridge, well done. Beautiful video, really beautiful artwork. I will just say pyrolysis, not prolysis, but I mean, really, really beautiful stuff. So the sixth and final award. I'm calling this the Brian Cox Special Award for the person who most made a video that looked like a TV show. What was good about this video, in fact all the videos that I've highlighted really, is that they didn't try to explain everything about a particular topic. They focused in on one particular aspect of the topic. So this person who's going to win the Brian Cox Special Award, they focused in on a particular aspect of polymers in aerospace and aeronautics, and they focused on the Mars lander. And it has to be said, Sam Wainwright did a fantastic job of explaining how the Mars lander worked in TV style. Let's have a look.
Mars, our most Earth-like planetary neighbour, beckons. Its diverse surface, equal in area to Earth's land surface, has a fascinating history, punctuated by impact events, volcanism, tectonics, and erosion.
And as well as the glossy production values, there were some beautiful explanations of the polymer chemistry that made the Mars lander work. Why did this video work? Because it was a really interesting topic, it was a specific area, it was a very focused video, it focused in on that particular area, and it gave a real understanding of what had been done in polymer science and the way in which chemistry was allowing humankind to explore the universe around us, and that came across really well.
The landing procedure for Curiosity was far more complex than any other Mars landing mission due to the large mass of the rover. The landing relied heavily on plastics, or more precisely, polymers.
Hi, my name's Sam Wainwright, and in this video I will talk about how the versatility of polymers helped to land Curiosity on Mars.
The landing can be broken down into seven main steps, as described by this image. Upon entry into the Martian atmosphere, Curiosity's 4.5 metre diameter heat shield had to reduce the velocity of the spacecraft from 5.9 kilometres a second down to 405 metres a second, all in the time of about 4 minutes, in order for parachute deployment to be possible. The heat shield has to protect the Curiosity rover from the intense heat and friction that will be generated as the flight system descends through the Martian atmosphere. 1 minute and 15 seconds after entry, the heat shield experiences a peak temperature of up to 2,090 degrees Celsius. The material used in the heat shield is called pica and was developed in the 1990s by NASA. Pica is made by taking a porous carbon fibre material and filling the pores with a resin. This resin is a very specific kind of molecule called a polymer. Polymers are a repeating chain of monomers joined by covalent bonds.
In summary, about 35 videos were made, really fantastic stuff. Check out the full playlist of videos. Have a look at how inventive you guys have been in creating those videos. I know it's the prize winners that go away with their Amazon vouchers today, but you can all be really, really pleased with what you've done. I hope you've all learnt a lot by making the videos. I hope you'll all learn a lot more by watching and sharing the videos. And I hope you enjoyed doing this assignment. Thank you.